It's me, Stormy, and here's your weekly horoscope for the week of August 20th, and what a rockin' week we have got on our hands. Now, before we jump in, if you're still wanting to sign up for Astrology 101 by itself, or Astrology 101, 102, I've got 4 spots left. So if you're wanting to join, come on, get in. We kick off in September, okay? Details are in the description box down below, so check it out. Now, this week, we've got the sun changing sign, so we're going to move out of that Leo energy and move into Virgo energy, which is a different pace. We're going to focus differently. We've got a full moon happening in Pisces, and we've got one little square at the end of the week that I'm not too terribly worried about, because we've also got trine energy happening this week on Gorgeous, which is so good, because when there's a trine, we've been doing all this spiritual work and the material world actually gets an opportunity to really shine through. So let's jump in here and talk about what we see. Okay, so first of all, here on Monday, August 20th, we have got just a beautiful energy. We've got the sun and the moon in a perfectly delicious fire energy trine. Like, it's fire. It is literally fire. So on the 20th, you know what I mean? Allow yourself, be a little, not outspoken in a bad way, but speak up for some things. Where's your fire? Where's your play? Where's your passion? Where's your oomph, right? Like, so let's bring that to the table. Now, because I'll tell you, when we get to Thursday, which is actually the 23rd, the sun is going to leave that Leo fire energy and move into that earthy energy of Virgo. And this happens again on Thursday, August 23rd. Now, when the sun moves into Virgo, what do we want to do? We don't want to just be nitpicky, but you do. You want to pay attention to the details. And Virgos like clean, right? So wherever the Virgo energy hits for you in your chart, think about how you can clean up that area or how you can be of service to that area, right? And this is a really beautiful example, I think. So if you have, let's say, Virgo in the fifth house and the sun is going to be lighting up that area, where can you be of service to your children or to your cousins or to your own joy? Where can you be of service with this energy, right? Instead of showing up as a taker, where can you show up as a giver? And if you are traditionally the one who shows up as a giver, where can you clean that up so that the scale balances a little bit? I really like working with that Virgo energy. Now, the other thing that I think of when the sun comes into Virgo energy is if you have pets or you're into pets, especially small animals, this is a lovely, lovely energy for you. Okay. Now, again, like I said, this is also a good energy to clean up your diet if you needed to do that. Okay. Now, like I said, I feel like this is a wonderful energy when we have trines because the material world gets a little boost. So when we get here to Saturday the 25th, we've got the sun who's now moved over here into Virgo, and it's going to be moving into a grand trine with Uranus who's here in Taurus, Saturn who's here in Capricorn, and then that, first of all, having a grand trine is like, put me in, coach, let's do this, right? It is a wonderfully big pocket of opportunity for you to make progress personally, professionally. The opportunity is there, but you have to take the action, right? Now, right the next day from that, on the 26th, we've got the full moon happening in Pisces. And if you haven't watched my full moon in Pisces video, please make sure you do it, because I highlight the grand trine that's in there and then the opposition, the big red line of the full moon running right up the middle of it, okay? Now, here's what I'll tell you. This is a pretty cool kind of unique arrangement that we've got going on, because the full moon is saying something needs to be ended, acknowledged, or adjusted. And Pisces is a completion slash transition energy, right? So we're definitely going to be making a shift here. But that grand trine is a gift, you guys. It is a gift. If there's an opportunity you've been thinking about, praying about, it's been kind of in front of you, you've been unsure, if you know, like, this is your job, this is your apartment, this is your time, get ready to grab it, because this is not probably good. This is probably not going to be some brand new thing. This will likely be something that's been in the works for a while. Okay. So the other thing that I think this energy is great for, because Uranus is involved, is being creative. If there's a creative project, or you're needing to be creative, or maybe you're getting ready to perform or do something in a more creative sphere, this is a really wonderful energy to kind of give life to that. Now, the one square that is happening this week is going to be happening Later on the same day, on the 26th, we've got Venus and Pluto in a square, and it's later in the day on the 26th. So where I think that this can bring a little bit of bubble is you could be looking at things around relationships, maybe things with finances, things like that. But really, even with Venus and Pluto in a square, I don't feel like it like dampens the week. Now, if you have something significant going on in your chart that this is triggering, or it's been time for a nice big shift, if that's what your grand trine is about, is hey, trying to get these finances, it's time to get this relationship in order, really breathe it in. Even if it's scary, this is your opportunity to release something from the past and move forward into a much better, probably more successful, better suited future for yourself. So I love it. I can't wait to see what's happening for you guys this week. Please keep me posted down below. Where are these energies happening in your chart? What kind of decisions are you making? What are you moving towards? What are you moving away from? We just got done with an eclipse cycle. So everybody, and a retrograde cycle, please, we're still doing that. Everybody is moving to and from something right now, and it's a pretty nicely significant shift. So I can't wait to see what's going on for you, but don't waste these trines. Please don't waste these trines. They're too delicious, okay? All right, guys, like this video, comment, share, subscribe, get signed up, come study astrology with me if you need a reading. That's also in the description box down below. You need a natal chart so that you can know where these things are happening in your chart. You can find those at stormygrace.com as well. All right, you guys, I love you. Have a good week.